Greetings to all our viewers out there. Welcome back to our channel. I've got a clove and half an onion. I'm going to spike the clove and the onion. I'm going to make cauliflower cheese or cauliflower money. I've got 50 grams of butter. I'm going to melt that there. This is for flavor. But you can chop the onions finely and fry them in the butter. You can put in bay leaf, whatever flavors you like. I've got 500 ml of milk. I'm going to warm up here. And I've got 50 grams plain flour. I've got two small size of cauliflower, but I'm going to cook them all. I've got some hot water over there in stock, vegetable stock. So I'm going to cook them in vegetable stock. They also have to be almost of the same size. I'm going to cook it off to start off with, then drain the water out of it. But I'm making the bechamel, the same amount of flour to butter, but just a bit different. This one goes with cheese because of the cauliflower cheese. So I'm going to cook it in the water over there. The butter is almost melted. I'm going to add in the flour. So these are our three pots. That's the cauliflower cooking in the veg stock. I'm going to put the milk at the back. Just cook the flour and the butter slowly. But now you can see it's wet. But it's going to look cooked after. I'm going to season it. Some salt. And some pepper. I'll add in 50 to 100 grams of cheese. And for now, I just need to cook the flour. You can see the flour is cooked. So we're going to add in the milk gradually. And when you keep adding, it's going to be thickening. That's what it will look like. I'm going to use a whisk now, switch off the milk. Now we're just checking whether the cauliflower is cooked. Yeah, so now we're going to drain it off. Now I'm going to grate in 50 to 100 grams of cheese. So now I'm going to transfer it over there and finish it off. Going to put it together. Always arrange it nicely so it stands up. The florets are on the right side. When it's hot like this, the sauce goes on top. You can just finish it off under the salamander or the grill. But at the same time, you can cook it in the oven. And also add cheese on top. So little bit cheese on top. And I'm putting mine in the oven. When it's hot, it's alright to put under the salamander. So that's ready for the oven.